The store page is one of the most important things when it comes to launching your game on Steam, which is why it's very important to spend a lot of time polishing your page. In this video, I'm going to be going over all of the steps you need to know before creating your first Steam store page, and I'm going to do it by showing you what I did for my new game, Lul Inc. If you're a new developer, the first thing you're going to have to do is make a Steamworks account. You use your regular Steam account, and if you don't have one, you create one, and you're going to have to add additional info like if you have a company or not, and things like that. After your Steamworks account is set up, you're going to have to pay the $100 fee that comes with creating a new Steam project. If your game sells over $1,000 though, you will get this $100 back. But see it as an investment for now. Now you have a project in Steamworks, and you can start working on your actual store page. To actually publish the store page, you're gonna have to go through a checklist that Steam gives you. A lot of the things are very simple. A support mail, whether your game includes mature content or not, a release date, the publishers and the developers. When you click on the publisher or the developer, it will just take you to the search page with all of the games from those names. But you could create a community specific to your developer that people can follow on Steam. System requirements. Don't worry if you don't know exactly what the system requirements are. You can basically write whatever here. Basic info and a description. The basic info is what's displayed under the main capsule in the Steam page. And the description is the longer description at the bottom of the page. Here you can include GIFs if you want, videos. You should include that before you launch, definitely. But if you want to get your store page out as soon as possible, which I recommend, I wouldn't worry too much about the description, because I doubt a lot of people actually read the description before the game is launched. Then we get to the most important part of the store page. All of the images and capsules. The capsules is what people see the first time they see your game anywhere in the store page. If you have a good capsule, that can make the difference from a person clicking on the game and not clicking on the game. And there are a lot of capsules you're gonna need. You have the main capsule, which is a big capsule that you probably don't need to spend too much time on, since it will only be displayed if your game gets featured. And if you're watching this video, it won't, so don't worry too much about the main capsule. Then we have a slightly smaller capsule, which is called the header capsule. This is the capsule you see on the store page itself. You also see it a lot in the store when you're browsing, you know, your friends' recommendations, stuff like that. So definitely spend a lot of time on that one. But then we have the most important capsule, I believe, and that's the small capsule. And this is the capsule you see the most of in the store page. You see it when you browse a lot of games, when you search for games. If you're not gonna spend time on anything else, spend time on the small capsule. Speaking of small capsules, I had an internal discussion with my artist about what small capsule we should use. We decided on the right one, but what do you guys think? Should we use the left one or the right one? We also have the vertical capsule, which I couldn't even see anywhere in the store page, so I'm not really sure where it's used. So don't waste too much time on that one. The library hero and the library logo, which can be viewed when you're on a game's page in your own library. The library capsule, which is viewed when you're viewing all of your games in your library. The icon, which is the small icon you see next to the game when you browse all of your games. Since people will already have bought your game when they view these, you shouldn't spend more time on these than you do on the small, main and header capsules. And finally, the community capsule, which I'm not even sure where it's viewed. Another very important thing you're gonna need to set up before launching your store page is tags. You're gonna have to choose at least 5 tags that describe your game. But you can choose up to 20, and I don't see why you wouldn't choose 20. If you're a small developer and you know that your game probably won't sell a lot of copies, I would suggest choosing tags that are very descriptive. If you put indie or action at the top, your game will just disappear among the other games in those categories. So choose the smaller categories which are high information about your game. Another very important art thing you're gonna have to do is make 5 screenshots of your game. And the screenshots, they have to be actual screenshots from your game. You can't edit them too much. And the screenshots are very important, since that's what people will view when they think about if they want to wishlist it or not. So make sure to actually have finished art in your game before you publish your store page. at least enough so that you can get 5 screenshots out of it. The last thing you want to consider for your store page is if you want to have a trailer or not. For us, we felt that actually publishing the store page is more important than making the trailer. So instead of waiting until we had enough content to actually make a trailer, we decided to push the store page first and then make the trailer as our second priority as soon as possible. Now you're gonna be all set and done. Send your store page in for review to Steam. It will take 2 to 3 days. When I published my first game on Steam, I got rejected the first time and they told me that I hadn't written a descriptive enough description of the game. So spend at least some time on making sure the description is a few paragraphs long. But other than that, there shouldn't really be a big problem. If they approve your page, you'll get a mail and then you can go into Steamworks and actually publish the Steam page. And from there, people can finally go and wishlist your game. Speaking of wishlists, you can go and wishlist my game Lul Inc. right now. The link is down in the description. I hope you learned something from this tutorial / devlog. I will share more info about Lul Inc. in the future, so make sure to subscribe, and I will see you guys next time. Peace.